So good afternoon all. I hope I can do justice to this talk, and I'm going to give this talk on behalf of my uncle who couldn't be present here. He's a vitreoretinal surgeon, and he says that my main practice is endophthalmitis, and he earns from endophthalmitis. So that is his financial disclosure. So there are various factors. It's like a six blind men trying to figure out with an elephant what is happening when there is an endophthalmitis prevention. Everyone has a different take on how we should prevent endophthalmitis. So right today we are talking about intracameral antibiotics, and each of the person has a controversial role on how it happens, because there are various factors. It's just not the intra part. It can be because of the host, it can be because of the commensals, it can be because of the surface, it can be because of the sterility issues, it can be because of the operative conditions, the surgeon conditions, the organisms around it. It's not just one thing, and it can also be because of the post-operative reasons like wound structure and conjunctival flora. So just using an intracameral, will it prevent endophthalmitis? It's like old wine in a new bottle. We used to use it before. And this is one of the studies which was published 40 years back, and I think Arvind Madurai was involved in this study, where they had two groups, in which one they had not used intracameral antibiotics, and in one which they had used it, and they said that there was only 3.37% ratio in the group which was used. It was 40 years back. Pioneers themselves never believed in their findings because they did not practice themselves for 40 years, and then they brought in practice right now. So is it justified? Ma'am just spoke about the ESCRS study. So here is the ESCRS study where they have used, where they have proven that with intracameral, the incidence is just 0.01 to 0.08% in the ESCRS study. But there is another study by Mayo Clinic where they have said, where they have not used the intracameral antibiotics, they have just taken care of the preoperative septic aseptic conditions, and the rate is equal, the rate is less than that, 0.03%. So it is even less than the ESCRS study. So an advanced country like USA, not possible to replicate, at least in India, and they say that if it's not necessary to use intracameral antibiotics. Also, this is one of the other studies published in 2009, where they've said that if we take care of pre-op cleaning of eyelids, periocular skin, and we use proper povidone iodine, take care of the OT sterilization and everything, then no intracameral antibiotics are needed. In this study, all the patients did not receive any antibiotics in the irrigating solutions, no subconjunctivals or intracamerals used. And also, there we all know that in Bihar, which is the Bodh Gaya massive eye camp, there are massive surgeries happening every year. They do not use intracameral antibiotics. Still, their endophthalmitis rate is very less, which is 0.02%. As ma'am suggested, that yes, there is no randomized control trial happened in this use, whether it should be used or not, and for any FDA trial, it is necessary. So how can we say that it is safe? And this is one of the barriers against using the same. This is one another study from the India, which is a large scale study, and they say that there is no evidence to support that intracameral use will reduce the rate of acute endophthalmitis after cataract surgery. And as we said, one of the most common problem of this retrospective study is they do not take into account the improvement in asepsis and operative techniques during the same study periods, which may account the decline in rate of endophthalmitis. Also, a less obvious limitation of database studies includes inaccuracy in diagnosis and procedure coding, particularly with the use of different international classification of disease, which is the 10th edition. So for purulent endophthalmitis and other endophthalmitis. Also, coming to the pharmacokinetics of the drugs, if you use an intracameral antibiotic, it just stays for 4 to 5 hours after surgery, and it eliminates after that. But if we see, the endophthalmitis actually starts after that. So are we justified using intracameral antibiotics? Also, we should not forget the complications when we use intracameral antibiotics. So that also needs to be taken into account. Facts point somewhere else, that intracameral antibiotic will only lead to reduction of AC contamination and reduction of post-cataract endophthalmitis. But what about the flora, conjunctiva, and the commensals? Because conjunctiva is a primary source of bacteria causing post-op endophthalmitis, and it is proven in literature. Also, the role of intracameral antibiotics remains controversial in the United States, and they are associated with increased costs, risk to individual patient, and risk to population at large by contributing to the emergence of drug-resistant organisms. also prevention of cataract and ophthalmitis. If as I said before, aseptic precautions, proper sterilization, peri-wound closure, perioperative topical antibiotics, povidone, iodine before and after surgery, no need of intracameral antibiotics. It's time we start being smart. And the main concern, off-label drug promotion. We all know that few years back, there was a scenario of when they had used Avastin, which was the off-label, there was a massive endophthalmitis after using intravitreal Avastin. So are we justified using off-label intracamerals? Though if there are any complications like PCR and all, we would definitely use it because comparison is a thief of joy. So in the patients, high-risk patients, if we require it, we should go ahead and use it. Thank you.